is a terrific young man. We've got an exciting older group he and Kata Bates Diop. We all know it here that Kata had a difficult year last year being injured, but he's back now. Banged knee, so he's been out for about 7 or 8 days, but he's fully healthy now, and we're really excited about the year that he can have, and excited about our leadership with Jay Sean and Kata. And obviously we have Cam, who is also a fifth year senior as well, added Andrew Dockage from that team up north there. He gives us some veteran ball handling as well. So this is a fun group. It's been a fun group to coach so far. You know, I had one of them tell me at the Big Ten media day the other day, he goes, "Coach, you can tell being here that the outside world doesn't have a whole lot of expectations of this group, or doesn't think much of this group." And I said, "Well, listen, all we can control right now is what we do every day, and we will determine what that looks like. And our goal is to reach the fullest potential with this group. And I think if you have really good kids who are willing to work each and every day and have the right approach and the right attitude, then you have a real chance to reach your team's full potential, whatever that is." And we're on practice right now, practice 18 today. Now, when you have 18 practices and you've yet to play any outside competition, and then your first game is still, you know, 7 to 10 days away, 2 weeks away, this can be the challenge. I have to pull all of my psychological tricks to keep our group motivated. This is kind of the dog days of October for all of us right now, in terms of keeping our teams alert and ready and focused on getting better each and every day, because they've been hitting each other for a number of days now. But been really pleased with their attitude and approach, and we are excited to, you know, as a coaching staff, we get really excited every day to get up in the morning and come in to work with this group. So can't tell you enough how excited we are. And you got a chance, obviously, to get to know our staff here. You know, we have Dave, who has literally held our hand through these last couple months. He's been here for 13 years and showed us the way around here. We have our coaching staff that we brought from Butler, and then we have a nice blend. Obviously got Scooney, who we all love, the kind of player he was and the person he is. Quager and Banks, he's been a super addition in our strength program. He looks a lot meaner than he really is. He's really a terrific guy. I think you're going to enjoy getting to know them. They're going to stick around here a little bit this evening, and you get a chance to kind of talk to the assistant coaches. They wanted to do that. The staff wanted to do that. You know, I know this. I had a couple people as I was on the road this past year say to me, "Hey, Coach, I had another Big Ten coach say to me, "Hey, Coach, one of the things you have to do, you're going to have to work really hard, is you've got to get the Schottenstein Center rocking again." That's what they said. "You got to get the Schottenstein Center working. You got to get it working." So that is going to be, he said, "Hey, from the student section on." And obviously, we have a responsibility with that, right, in terms of our play. We hope you come and watch us play, and then you say, "I want to come back and watch that team again because of the heart and the passion they played with." That's what we're going to work exceptionally hard, trust me, to make that happen. And I think our guys know it may not go perfect this year, but as long as we have a great approach, we'll feel good about what the outcome is going to be. So what I want to do is just open it up to maybe some questions that you might have. And they can range from anything. Trust me, I've done this a number of times, and I've gotten every question you can imagine. So it's wide open. Any questions you might want to ask me about our team, our program, our players, schedule, future schedule, upcoming schedule, I'll just knock them out right now. So what questions might we have here? Yes, ma'am. Is it November 10th? I've been asking myself that. Is it November 10th yet? You know, are you excited? Yeah, so am I. I'm pretty excited too. I cannot wait for that to happen. It's coming soon enough. Yes, sir. I'm right back there. Oh, wow. We have a future coach in the house. He asked if we're going to play more zone D or man D this year. And good question, young man. What's your name? David. Good question, David. You know, we'll be primarily a man-to-man team, but we will play some zone for sure as a secondary defense, but it will be primarily man-to-man. We're not going to play. If you're looking at us and you watch us play, you say, hey, that team plays a lot of man-to-man, but there definitely will be some zone mixed in. And we have some depth concerns, so that might lead us to playing a little bit more zone. We have some depth concerns on the perimeter. But it would be primarily man-to-man. Yes. Oh, how much are we going to beat that team up north by? You know, we're going to beat them as bad as we can possibly beat them. We're going to try to beat them as bad as we can possibly beat them. That's certainly going to be our goal. We got a few games between now and then, but I appreciate that. That's a real Buckeye right there asking that question, right? That is a real Buckeye. Yes?
You came from a conference that had some really tough schools. Villanova, Xavier.
Yes.
How do you think what you played against will prepare to Big Ten?
Great question. So how do I think a Big East compares to the Big Ten? I'm really anxious to see that. You know, last year, the conference that I came from got 70% of its team in the NCAA tournament, 7 out of 10 teams. We were a 4 seed, Villanova was a 1 seed. And I think it's going to be very comparable. But what I've heard from guys that have been in both leagues as assistants is the play is very similar, the road venues are more difficult to play in the Big Ten, just because Big Ten has led the nation in attendance the last 41 years. So home and away, it's a fantastic environment. But I think the style of play will be interesting to see. And I've heard some comments about the officiating in both leagues. And I'll keep those to myself right now. Maybe that'll take place in a one-on-one conversation here. But it'd be very interesting to see how comparable. Yes, sir.
Last year they had a lot of trouble with making free throws. They've been talking about 5 or 6 more games. What are you doing to address that?
Well, we intend to work on it. I thought I might get a free throw question. One of our best players, right, terrific young man is Jay Sean Tate. He struggled from the line. So, you know, what we've got to do is try to get him to have his best year from the free throw line, because he's going to get there, right? You know, Cam Williams, I'd love for him to get to the line as much as JT does. So in my mind, we have to get those guys that we know are going to be high-volume free throw shooters to improve in their free throw shooting. And it's just going to take some practice and belief from us. I don't think there's anything structurally wrong with Jay Sean's shooting. I think in some cases it was maybe a case of concentration and focus as much as anything. I'm going to want Jay Sean on the line and those guys on the line late game situations, and believe we're going to get it done for us in those situations. It's interesting, the thing I've heard most about our group, and when I say our group, I really mean that our group, is we struggled with adversity when we got knocked around last year. I heard this from other Big Ten coaches. We struggled with adversity, and we weren't always as tough as we needed to be. So those are things we've really been challenging our guys with. Yes, sir. Non-conference scheduling, I've been asked that a few times, for sure. I would like for it to be, if I'm going to air, it's typically going to be a more challenging non-conference schedule. I'm going to air, if you look at kind of what we've done in the past, because you want it to be set you up to prepare you to have a chance at an at-large berth in the NCAA tournament, and then also prepare you for the NCAA tournament. And in order to do that, you have to have the opportunity to get some signature non-conference wins. That's my belief. And that's clearly been proven by all of the data, right? So, we're going to try to do that. Now, we can't play, right? We can't play 10 games versus North Carolina in the non-conference. That's not feasible. There will be some teams and programs that are, really good, but may not be name-type programs that basketball people would understand are pretty good, that are going to come in here. But I think with what we've done with Cincinnati and the scheduling that we've done there, we're trying to provide. We have some, I will tell you this right now, we have some scheduling challenges with, now that the Big Ten went to 20 games, we have some signed agreements, the Big East Big Ten Challenge, the CBS Classic. So we have some limitations. We don't have a whole lot of games left to schedule. But the ones that we do, trust me, we're going to try to provide a game or two here. We'd like to provide two or three, kind of, if we could every year provide, two high major opponents that you guys would be really excited about in the non-conference, I think that would be an exciting thing, and we'll try to do that. Yes, ma'am.
As a fan, I'd just like to thank you for that. Having sat in these seats and wanted to see Cincinnati and Dayton and all of these teams that surround us. I just want to thank you for starting out on that.
Yeah, thank you. Well, it's a bit of a risk, but I'm fine with it. And when I say risk, listen, those are really quality programs, right? And I think we really benefited when we were. When I was at Butler, by playing in a classic with Indiana, Purdue, Notre Dame, and Butler, it was really fun. As a matter of fact, I have not said this publicly, but we tried to get something like that started, and we even broached that subject. We haven't been able to get anything like that yet, but I think down the road that would be really, really fun for all the fan bases. And those are really, if you beat one of those programs, that's right now that's a quality win for us. Cincinnati and those teams are top 25 programs right now. So we got a lot to gain, right, by playing that. Certainly I want to provide that for you guys as a fan base. So.
What are your thoughts on playing conference games
in
December?
Yeah, it's changed from the Big Ten to going conference game. I've done it one other time in my career, and it's like you're going. So now we have two Big Ten conference games in December. And you've never done that before. So you're thinking non-conference, 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 and then you have to really switch your focus, right? Because it's you guys know this, it's a different feel when you're playing Big Ten games. The intensity gets ratcheted up. I lose a lot less sleep, which means I get no sleep. So I think for us, it's what's been, what we're trying to do in college basketball, I think, is provide exciting games earlier in the year, and I think that's what the Big Ten decided to do. I'll be great to you guys here, yes, ma'am.
Back to the free throws.
Yes, free throws.
Win or lose makes the game, right? And you said we are going to practice. My question is, actually, when you say we're practicing, you're lining them up, they got to do 50, or I want to know exactly, because that has been a big problem the last few years.
Yeah.
And also, the team looks exciting.
Oh,
yes,
really,
they do.
Thank you. Yeah, I think they're excited about this time of year, and they're an excited group to coach, and I appreciate you saying that. We chart every free throw in practice. We have them, we didn't do it today because of time, but we chart every free throw. We'll shoot 25 or 50, five at a time, if you want to know exactly kind of how we do it. And we have every free throw charted. I have a in my office a sheet with all of their percentages right now. So we're monitoring it pretty closely. You know, at the end of the day, what I've found the best growth that can happen in free throw percentage is for your team to really know that you trust and believe that they're gonna make the ones that are in front of them. Trust that they've had practice and believe in them and show that you have confidence in them. So I don't want to get in their head too much on that, but I understand it has been an issue for us. Yes, sir. Ball handlers this year, gonna be CJ, Jay Sean Tate, Andrew Dockich, Kata Bates Dia will be a ball handler. Those kind of guys come to mind. Musa Jallo, but probably our three point guards would be CJ, Jay Sean, and Andrew Dockich. Yes, sir. Who will our starting lineup be? Wow, you're getting right to it. Yes. I at this point, I don't know. I couldn't give you a starting lineup for sure because I just don't know. You know, I wish I could tell you more. I don't know what our starting lineup is going to be. That's still kind of an evolving process. I'm still evaluating them on a day-to-day basis on that. Yes. You've got a career in reporting there. That's an impressive question. But, watch out, Adam, okay? All right. The expectations, he said, you know, it's interesting. One of our assistant coaches has all the stuff from the preseason, all the prognostications, and has it up on his wall in his office, Ryan Peden. So you see, 13th place and 11th place, as you mentioned, 12th place. You know, I think, to be honest with you, I hadn't even seen that until I walked in there today and kind of was like, oh, they said that about us. And, for us, a successful season is going to be improving with each passing month. Can we become better with each passing month? Can we become a more tighter group, a more connected group, a group that understands how to win more and more with each passing month? And then can we, you know, be a group that reaches our potential? I don't know exactly what that's going to be right now. I know it's really fun when you play games in February and March that matter. In other words, you know, you're in conversation for postseason play. Those are fun games to be a part of when you're. So that's what's going to be our goal is to get in those kind of conversations. One last couple here, yes, sir. Yep, good question. Perception of the program, I think, you know, I'm very excited about the four commitments that we have that I can't speak about, you know, specifically and publicly, but just really excited. I think when you come in here next year, you're gonna really enjoy those additions. You know, we have certainly had plenty of programs that have challenged us with, okay, how quickly are they going to get to the NCAA tournament? They're going to struggle for a few years, whatever the case may be. That negativity has been out there, but I think the exciting thing for us is we've been able to communicate to recruits, hey, listen, this is a proud program that has the ability, we believe, to be really good quickly, and what we have right now is a great opportunity for playing time. Tremendous opportunity for playing time. And we want guys that are saying, hey, listen, I want to grab that, and I want to be part of this program, be a big part of helping this program be successful. And the four guys that have jumped on board, that's been a big, big factor for them. But, you know, we've had to fight some of the negativity for sure on the recruiting trail. There's no question about it. And I'm excited about the guys that have said, I want to be a part of that thing when it gets back to being an elite program.
There's a couple more here, and then we're going to go.
Okay.
I'm going to ask, what do you foresee as the offensive identity of the team? Like,
will press much. I don't think we will. I just have not done it a whole lot. We might do some three-quarter press some this year, but I've, that'll be kind of later on potentially. We'll play primarily man-to-man, aggressive. I'd like to play an attacking, fast pace offensively. Some of that will depend on our overall depth and how healthy we remain. That's how I'd like to play, is a fast, aggressive, up-tempo style, but we also need to be really efficient half-court offensively as well. Our best teams have been that way this year. Did it? Both of them, right? Doesn't matter.
Based on the recruiting, what you were just speaking of, the with the problems some of these other universities are having at the moment, I know there's a couple, I was just in Colorado, and a couple of kids just decommitted from Arizona. Will that have any effect on our program here?
It might. We'll have to vet those situations appropriately for obvious reasons. He was talking about all the stuff that's went on in the recruiting college basketball world nowadays. And it's, listen, it can be at times, I'll just say, an interesting world recruiting. But we'll have to vet all those situations to make sure they're the right fits for us. But we definitely are doing that. Yes, we are.
First of all, welcome to Ohio State.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you. You've come to love Ohio State basketball as much as I do. And my question for you is, what is your ultimate goal as a basketball coach at Ohio State? And be careful. There's only one right answer.
That's why I came here. That's why I came here. And I believe that if it could be, I certainly believe it can be done here. I think it was done here, right? So it can be done here.
57 years ago.
I know. It's been a while, but we've also been pretty close at times in the last. Right, 20, 30, 40 years, and we just, it's gonna take some time. We recognize that, and I think if you're gonna have prolonged success in a program that is stable, it's gonna take a little bit of time, but we dig it in, and that is certainly my ultimate goal for sure. I gotta just answer one more of these young people's questions, Dave, and then we're out. I don't know how to pick him. You look so, yes, I have to. I'm afraid something's going to happen if I don't answer your question. What freshman am I excited to see play this year? All of them. All three of them. We have, did you see the three freshmen out here? Caleb, Wesson, he's big, isn't he? He's big. Coach Juan and staff did a great job recruiting him. And Kyle Young and Musa Jallo, all three of those guys are going to play important roles for us. They really are. We're very grateful that we were able to recruit that group here as late as we were able to. That's not very common, but I think we got three really solid players there. Really do. Hey, thank you so much for your time and being here, and we will see you. We'll see. All right. We'll see you up at dinner.